What's up, enthusiasts? Today, I'm finally answering your AMA questions. And first off, I just want to thank all of you that submitted questions. I really appreciate it, and I'm really excited to get to these. So I actually didn't go through and pre-read all of them and think of responses. I wanted to do it kind of on the spot. I thought that would be more fun and potentially more interesting. So with that said, let's just dive right in. I've got my tablet with the questions loaded up, so we're just going to get to it. First off, I've got Sergeant Silent asking, are you a bigger fan of flywheels or springers? And Foam Fighter is actually piggybacking on top of that, asking stringers or air power. So I'm just going to add all four of them together, and I am a flywheels fan. At least personally, myself, I like flywheels. I do enjoy springers. I've got, you know, a few of my own. I haven't done too much with air power. I mean, I've got the Mag Strikes and the Rapid Madnesses, which I enjoy. The Mag Strikes more than the Rapid Madness. You guys have seen what happens when I use a Rapid Madness. It's not fun, unfortunately. But speaking of air power, if we had more of the HPA or LPA stuff here where I play, I think I might be more of a fan of it. I think some of the things that have been done with it are just absolutely phenomenal. You know, look at Zomboni with his Rapid Madness, or I think it's like Liam. I'm not going to try for the last name because I'm going to say the wrong last name and look a fool, even though I already have at this point. But yeah, he's done, like, I think it's called the Red Baron, and that thing is like a semi-automatic HP or LPA blaster that just shoots ridiculously well. So check that out if you're a fan of air-powered blasters. But to the question, flywheels for myself. Kind of got off on a tangent there, sorry. Rob SBNC asks, how do you keep your hair so immaculate? And I don't know if I would call it immaculate, because, well, if I'm not constantly fiddling with it, it ends up doing this, which, that's not too good looking. So I'm pretty much, throughout the day, I'm always just doing this with my hair, fiddling with it to get it to look decent. So yeah. James Hargrave asks, will you be going to MVZ? MVZ already happened. I was not able to make it, which I am so bummed about. I'm really, really hoping that next year I will be able to go, because just being able to meet everyone and hang out and play a big game of HVZ sounds awesome. So fingers crossed, here's hoping. Extreme Kangaroo asks, do you have a significant other and do they nerf? If not, what's their opinion on nerf? I do have a significant other. She does not nerf, but she is supportive of my nerf hobby and YouTube channel and is just a generally awesome person. So yay me for that. Foam Fighter asks, what gear would you recommend for someone around 13 to 14? The age isn't really going to tell me what needs to be known. It really comes down to body size. The thing I can say is that Blastersmiths UK will build their gear to suit your body. So you tell them what your measurements are and they will make it fit you, which is fantastic. So take advantage of that. They might not be as cheap as getting something, you know, off the rack from like Amazon or a surplus store, but they'll make it to fit and it'll last and it'll hold Nerf stuff because it's purpose made for Nerf. So I highly recommend it. One of my favorite pieces of gear is still my battle belt, which is relatively affordable. And I don't want this to sound like an ad, but really I do like their stuff and I recommend them whenever I get the option to. So check that out for your gear sizing needs. Evan B. Nerf, two-part question. A, what is your favorite ice cream flavor? And B, how much of said ice cream could you eat in one sitting? So, favorite ice cream color is probably rainbow sherbet. Yeah, rainbow sherbet. Cookie dough might come in a close second, but rainbow sherbet, that's where it's at. How much of it could I eat in a sitting? Sadly, none anymore. I cannot have eggs, which sucks. Among other things, I can't eat because I have stomach problems. But I can no longer eat eggs. So eggs are kind of a
important component of ice cream. So yeah, I don't really do ice cream anymore, which is a bummer. But rainbow sherbet, it's where it's at. Oh, I'm going to butcher this name. I am so sorry. Ahead Ejusi? Oh, man. I'm so sorry. I'm sure I ruined that. Strife versus Rapid Strike. It's worth making a video on. I'm sure there are many videos out there that have done that. I'm actually in the Strife camp for this one. I obviously have several Rapid Strikes, which are behind me right now, but I clearly like them, but I think the Strife is a solid platform. It's also more compact, so I lean towards Strife. They're both fantastic blasters, but I go Strife. The Nerf Beaver. How did you come up with your logo? And if you couldn't use Phylos for a day, what Springer would you use? My logo was actually made by my girlfriend. She is a graphic designer, and she is awesomely talented. So she actually just kind of made that logo on a whim on a plate at like a petroglyph-style place where you paint like ceramics, and they fire it for you, and you come pick it up, and hey, I got a plate or a, you know, whatever. But yeah, she was just there and just happened to paint a plate for me, and I loved the logo. It's like, can you turn this into a computer file for me to use? And it's like, yes, and now it's everywhere for me because I love it. That thing is awesome. Oh, and if I couldn't use flywheels for a day, what Springer would I use? That would be the Retalifab. It's fabulous. I mean, Gavin Fuzzy pump grip kit is awesome. Highly recommend. Along with, obviously, an upgraded spring and whatnot. But yeah, that's what I would use. How do you get free Nerf guns? Blaster Brothers ask. I don't get free blasters usually, so I can't really answer that one. My channel is far too small to be on the radar of companies like Hasbro, Buzzbee, Zuru, Zing, etc., etc., etc. So I have to buy or borrow the blasters I use for review. So yeah, I do not have a good answer for you. Derpfails asks, are you going to mod the Hyperfire? Nope. It was not my Hyperfire. It was BFU's. Basically, piggybacking off that last answer, that wasn't my blaster. He just lent it to me to review because he's an awesome guy. And yeah, I went back to him. Favorite blaster of all time, MikeMan231 asks, right behind me, a Secret Shot. It is wonderfully fun. I did a video on it, actually, for Walcom's channel. So, if you're not following or subscribed to Walcom, I don't know why you're not, first off, but you can go check that out and see the video on there for that blaster. Do Silly Bing Films. What got you into Nerf? Do you play any video games? If so, what games? What was your first Nerf blaster? What is your job? Okay, there's a few to get through for this. So, what got me into Nerf? I nerfed as a kid. I think a lot of people did. I stopped for a while. Didn't really think much about Nerf for a long time until I was... I date myself here because I'm... not as young as I'd like, until I was in my mid-20s, I think. And, like, the Elite stuff was just starting to come out. So some friends and I kind of just picked up some Nerf stuff, started plinking around. It was like, oh, this is a lot of fun. And then did some searching online and found the Burn guys. Started going to their games and realized, like, this was an actual hobby. This is actually kind of big and kind of awesome. And then from there, I just kind of... it destroyed my other hobbies, and it became my pretty much primary hobby, and I've spent a lot of time doing it and loving it. So yeah, I'm really glad we just happened to pick up some blasters from Toys R Us one day and get into it, and that got me to start looking for other groups, and yeah, the rest snowballs from there. Do you play any video games? Yes, a lot of video games. Yeah, I think it's easier to just say I play a lot of video games rather than listing off the games I play, because I'm a big gamer. I was a competitive gamer for a while when I was younger, so that means I played a lot of Counter-Strike in leagues and tournaments and LANs and stuff like that. So I love gaming. Yeah. My first Nerf blaster. I can't remember. It might have been the Secret Shot. There's two blasters I remember having as a kid, distinctly. One was a Secret Shot. Okay, three. Secret Shot, Defender T3, and then a Super Max 5000, which, so sad I don't have anymore because those things are amazing. But yeah. What is your day job? I actually currently don't have a day job. I won't go into this too heavily. Maybe I will some other time, but basically, I had some health issues that prevented me from being able to keep a steady job. So I had to just take a break from working, unfortunately, to get health under control. So yeah, not gonna go too far into that. Maybe another time, like I said. But yeah, that's sadly not working a job right now. Hopefully, we'll find a good job that I love doing soon. Let's see. Extreme Kangaroo asks, what is your favorite Nerf game mode? Oh, that's tough. It's between CTF and King of the Hill. That's for sure. And I think it really comes down to the size of teams and the field that's being played on. So it could be either of those two. Unfortunately, I can't narrow it down to one. How did you meet the AOE people? For those of you who don't know, AOE is a gaming channel I do with my friends where I'll do a video like once a month for the channel. It's kind of a collaborative channel where we all make videos and about gaming to kind of supplement our own channels and just kind of do group stuff like that and have fun. I met them through cosplay for the most part. Kagor is my brother, so I know him from him being my brother, and the rest, yeah, all came from cosplay. Cosplay was one of my hobbies before Nerf, so yeah, met a lot of good people through that, and I'm, you know, glad I'm still hanging out with them. Extreme Kangaroo asks, how was my day? My day was not bad overall, I'll give you that. First time I tried to film this earlier, actually, and I had a cup of water, like, sitting right down here. And I was like, oh, you know, I don't want anything to knock this water over, because I got carpet here, and then I got exposed wood right over there. So I got to be careful. Let me move this thing out of the way, this blaster out of the way, so it doesn't spill and ruin everything. So I picked the blaster up, and there's a cord right here for one of the lights. It got caught in the cord, knocked the glass of water over, and it just everywhere. So that was a frustrating part of the day, but we got it cleaned up, and we're here, and we're doing this, and we're having a good time now. So overall, day's been good, but I thought I'd share that with you. Benjamin Slez asks, what is your favorite Nerf series, and what kind of series do you want Hasbro to come out with? I'm guessing you mean like Elite or Doomlands or like those kinds of like lines. Performance Elite, obviously, that just, it stepped the game up for Nerf. Aesthetically, that's a tough one. I've got a Mana Ray up here for the Max Force line. Some of those are really fun. Yeah. I don't know. That's a tough one. The Max Force line might have been the most fun-looking Nerf blasters. I think that we'll go with fun-looking. Performance and fun-looking. Performance Elite, fun-looking, probably Max Force. Odie Block asks, what kind of chronograph do you use? I have a Crony F1, I believe. It's the green one. I think the colors denote which version, I think, unless it's like F1 Alpha Beta or something like that. But yeah, it's the green one, the green crony F1. Nerflugs asks, how many blasters do you have? How many are modded and how many are stock? I have over 100 blasters. I think I did a count in my collection video. It has changed since then, but I think it's like 110, 120, somewhere around there. Blasters that are modded, 10 to 15 probably. The rest are probably stock. I'm not a big modder, like a lot of other people. I mod a few, and I use the word mod loosely because the modding I do is usually dropping stuff or kits that are pre-made or commissioning people to do that because I'm not much of a modder. I appreciate it and I love it and I think it's an amazing aspect of the hobby that pushes it forward and makes people think in creative ways, but it's just not something that I spend a lot of my time doing. Every now and then, yes, I do, but not huge. Will Reiner asks, wondering if you can weigh in on some issues that have baffled me. Blaster hits. Do you feel strongly they should count or not count as tags and why? And number two, future of Superstock Nerf. Can you make a wild prediction as to what forces may shape the world of Superstock Nerf over the next 5 to 100 years? Oh, that's a lot of time. All right. First one, blaster hits. I personally believe blaster hits should count as tags. It is just something that seems so fundamentally important. If you're using a blaster as a shield, it feels cheap to me. Like, it cheapens the value of a tag. Like, if I took 2 Chaos Blasters and ran at you holding them like this, side by side, like, you've got such a small amount to hit on me, and I'm on top of you, and I just turn one. And granted, I mean, it's not a quick turn, but I can turn them on you and just poof. Like, I don't know. I'm not a fan of blaster hits not counting as tags. I think they should count as tags. But that is just my personal opinion on that one. I know a lot of people like blasters blocking tags. So, to each group their own. Future of Superstock Nerf. Next 5 years. That's tough. I feel like Rival is going to continue to be on the rise. As more people get their hands on things like Hurricanes or even just LiPo'd and rewired Chaoses, they'll see performance go up and accuracy go up. And to me, a good Superstock game isn't a huge open field. You've got a lot of different engagement distances and cover and whatnot, so that will affect things, and you'll be able to find space to use the Rival stuff that maybe isn't as great at distance shooting, but is accurate and can put volume down. I'm sure we'll still see some people running Rapid Strikes and Stripes. The future is with the aftermarket parts. We will see aftermarket kits become more and more common, which they are already doing between Black Steel Props, DRS or Dr. Snickus, Worker, Artifact. I mean, all these companies are pushing things out to increase performance, increase accuracy. And those things are just going to continue to be on the rise. And this might sound a bit presumptuous, but we're kind of in the infancy stage of our hobby, kind of like paintball was, I think, way back when. Like, we're just starting to get all these companies starting to create things, and we've got the Draugr project that is working on Superstock blasters they sell just done, ready to go. You drop a battery in, you're good. And I think once those hit, we're going to see things kind of explode, because they'll be the first to market, or first or second to market, depending on how long it takes them, with fully designed, functional, custom blaster. I shouldn't say custom, mass-produced blasters of their own design. And that, to me, is when the hobby is going to start exploding towards Superstock as the way to go, because you will very easily be able to get your hands on those types of blasters. You won't need to mod. You won't need to go, I don't have the skills, the equipment to do this. Can I get some, like, IMRs and put this in? Will I still be competitive? You know, no, you can just straight buy a blaster, drop a battery in, and be good. So that's, I think, where we'll be from five. That's where I think we'll be 5 years from now, is that third-party blasters will also be a close to or a mainstay of the Nerf scene. 100 years? I don't know. I mean, if I could be alive in 100 years, that'd be kind of neat. That'd be a long life, but yeah, that'd be kind of neat to see where things are at. I honestly, that's too hard for me to predict. Micah? I want to say Micah. Climby, how long are your Nerf Wars? Nerf Wars usually go between 4 and 5 hours. I'd say that's a decent average. You'll usually get like 6 or so games in, about 15 minutes apiece. So that's, what, an hour and a half of playing. Sometimes you can get 7 or 8. But you gotta figure there's a lot of picking darts up, taking breaks to reload, get water, eat, you know, hang around. So yeah, that's about the average length we go. Neptune nerfing. Okay, so I have two questions that I could come up with. One, do you ever think there'll be another true competitive Nerf tournament akin to those of the Dart Tag series? And number two, do you ever think that the NIC will make any more significant Springer modifications other than just replacing Spring and disabling or removing ARs? So number one, the competitive Nerf, it is something we're working on. If you haven't seen the vlog from a few weeks ago, I think it was, we had our first test day for a 5v5 competitive Nerf format. It's something we've actually had in the works. We started working on the rules like 3 years ago. It's just taken us a while to actually get things moving. So we finally started testing, which I'm thrilled about. And I actually am waiting for Josh to come over, Josh of Bay Area Nerf, so we can do some commentary on one of those matches and I can upload the matches to all of you. So yes, I do think we will see competitive Nerf. It's something I am pushing for and want to see happen. It's just one more thing that will add another layer to the hobby that people can get into and enjoy and love. There's also other groups that are doing similar things. Like there's like a Melbourne group that does like tournament days. There's also the Rival League in Texas that's just kicking off. They're using like all stock Rival Blasters in hopes that maybe Hasbro will support them, which, I mean, if that happens, that's awesome. It's official support, which would be crazy. But yeah, it is happening. It is going to happen. It's, I think, the natural evolution of the hobby. You'll have casual games. You'll have competitive games. And that way, people can play what they want. And as far as the NIC and Springers and their future, I think that depends on what the internals of Springers are looking like. You know, as long as they stay the same or close to the same and people feel they've exhausted all the possibilities, probably not. Until someone, you know, people are always going to be trying to find something, but I'm sure someone eventually will figure something out, but right away in the near future, like the next 6 months or something, probably not. But people are always trying to find new things to do. So people are always innovating. They're always adding things or changing things. I think that's not going to stop. But in terms of finding like that next big, oh my God, must do performance enhancer, I have no idea. Like I said earlier, I'm not a big modder. So this, like, when it comes to modding questions, it's a lot of conjecture for me. People like, you know, Bobo, Walcom, Zambono, those are all people that have better answers for modding stuff than I will. But I'll give you what my thoughts are at the very least. Ted Savage asks, how old are you? Man, gonna make me date myself. Ted Savage, why are you so savage? I am currently 29. So now you know. Let's see. Benjamin Slez has a couple other questions. If you had to integrate sections of 3 Nerf blasters to make the best primary to suit you, what 3 blasters would you choose? Actually, what was I going to say? Oh, the Nobicon guys have three blasters of mine that are going to be combined into one blaster. So those are the stock of a flyer, the stock of a firefly, the body of a raven, and the front of a strife. So we're taking that Straven design, and instead of using that small raven buttstock, we're getting rid of that, and we're adding the firefly, like, meaty, nice, and comfy buttstock just to give some extra length to it so it's comfy and just give it that nice feel. Also, you know, some faux barrel stuff maybe or some attachments, whatnot. But yeah, those are the three blasters. I'm a heady on that one. Got something in the works. Looking forward to getting to use that. He also asked, do you prefer the Hyper Strike or the Rapid Strike? Definitely the Rapid Strike. If you're playing HVZ, Battle Belt or Chest Rig? Probably Battle Belt, for me at least. Jeffrey Young asked, do you like going as a heavy or a lighter class? Depends on the game. Like 100%. I enjoy doing both. It depends on the game and the style and what the people around me are doing. I like to kind of mix things up, so it's not always going to be the same for me. I definitely enjoy both. Andrew Huss asks, what loadout do you use when you're using your strife, and where did you get your gear from? Like I just said, the loadout changes all the time. I think the last loadout I used was my vest from Blastersmith UK, 3 double stack end mags, a dump pouch, and I think that was it. Yeah, I think I held like 8 mags total or 10 mags total, something like that. But yeah, honestly, I've got 2 big bins of gear, so answering where my gear came from, everywhere. I'm going to do a video on it at some point here, all the gear I have, because it's a lot. I'm a gear junkie. So yeah. Nerf Panda asks, what's your favorite Nerf gun? Answered that one. What is your most recommended Nerf gun? And will you do more loadout videos? Yes, more loadout videos. Waiting. I want to do them so bad. I just can't do them by myself because get everything to stay properly where it needs to be to film them, just it's not reliable by myself. Like, I'll set things up and they won't stay up. They'll fall, and it's just, it's frustrating. So I'm trying to get as many people as I can one day. I just haven't found that day yet where a bunch of people are available to come over and just film a ton of loadout videos that I can just, like, have ready and just get them out in a regular pace to all of you. Because I miss doing loadout videos so much. I really cannot overstate it. It is so much fun doing them. So yes, they are coming. Most recommended Nerf gun... it's probably a strife. Like, honestly, it's such a workhorse blaster that, you know, you can easily get to a good place. Gamer Ketchup asks, when will you dual wield Rapid Strike Uzis? I have no idea. I don't have any. I know maybe one person that has one, so probably not soon, unfortunately. Barney Newsom asks, do you think that the Nerf community should be more educated when it comes to lipos, wire gauge, amperage, voltage, and current draw? Yes. Just flat out, yes. It's an important thing. Amp Nerf asks, what are your favorite 3 Nerf blasters? I guess we'll add on then. We got the Secret Shot, Supermax 5000, which I don't have, sadly. And... third is tough. Maybe the Mag Strike. It may be the Mag Strike. There's just something really fun about it. But yeah, off the top of my head, like initial instinct reaction, that's probably what I'd go with. Jeffrey Young continues to ask, do you like dual wielding Nerf blasters? Sometimes. The Lawbringers. Oh man, dual wielding Lawbringers. Oh, definitely recommend. Not great blasters, but a lot of fun when you do that. Daniel Guthrie asks, how much gear is needed to be a gear junkie? Have you used duct tape to make gear? Why is your life Lego cosplay Nerf literally mine? Last part, I don't know. That's a little concerning. I hope it's not literally yours, because that'd be a little confusing. But, you know, hopefully you enjoy those hobbies at least, like I do. How much is needed to be a gear junkie? That's a good question. I don't know. Probably when you buy stuff you don't need. Like, I've got two vests, a battle belt, a chest rig, a plate carrier, and like multitudes of pouches, mag holders, slings, holsters, like just stuff. I could probably gear and arm a 5-person team by myself. And that's more than I will ever need for myself. I love gear. So yeah, that's probably where I would put that at. Let's see, next up. Favorite primary. Probably the Strife. And it just goes back to the Strife. It's just a great utility blaster. Like, it does everything I want it to and need it to. It's a solid workhorse. Hawkeye 007 asks, where did you get your logo and what is it? I answered where I got it from. It is a dragon. So yeah, thank you to my wonderful girlfriend again for that, because she is awesome. Stream Kangaroo asks, hardest mod you've ever done? Installing a drop-in kit on a rapid strike from Blaster Tech. That's about the difficulty level of the mods I do. So I'm just going to continue to drive that point home that I am not what I would consider a modder. So yeah. Just Joe asks, have you nerfed an MVZ? Nope. Hopefully next year, like I said earlier. Really, really hoping. I think this is pronounced Eggy ZX. We're going to go with that. Do you have any pets? I have one dog right now. Our family has a dog, I should say. It's a chocolate lab. It is like a year and a half old. It is crazy still. It has not calmed down. It is energetic, but it's a lovely dog. So yeah. Just Joe asks, would you go to Thunderdome? Yes. Oh, I want to go to Thunderdome. I am so sad I didn't get to go this year. But yes, I would love to hang out with Rob, play in Thunderdome. Like, the place just looks amazing. It's just such a wonderful story. So yeah, yes. Tiger Foam asks, how did you get into Nerf? We talked about that earlier. Favorite aspect of Nerf and some of my favorite Nerfers and channels. All right. Favorite aspect of Nerf. Community. It's easy to say, and I could also... See, you know, I'm a competitive person that feeds the competitive side of me to play in games and, you know, try and win and all that. But at the end of the day, I don't really care if I won or lost. So it comes down to the community. Being out, playing with friends, like running around, having fun, getting those stories of ridiculous tags that happen or crazy stuff that happens. Like, it's just, it's something wonderful that the community just comes together to hang out, and it's for the most part, really chill people. Really good people. I've met some awesome, awesome people through this hobby, and I'm so happy and grateful to know them. So that is one of my favorite parts of this hobby. And I hope that everyone that participates in this hobby gets to experience that. Gets to experience the welcoming people, the friendly people, the awesome people, the creative people, the smart people, all of them. I really love seeing people get connected and you know, talk and hang out and stay connected. It's a wonderful thing. So I know I said I wasn't going to go into the health issues earlier, but real quickly, Nerf is one of the things that got me out of the house when I was having issues to hang out with people and see people and be active. So it really is a great thing. It's a fantastic hobby that has done fantastic things for a lot of people. Whether it's as simple as just meeting some people or, you know, keeping you active or whatever, it's the community is just a fantastic aspect. So, and piggybacking off of that into the favorite nerfers and channels, you know, Bay Area Nerf guys, I've known them, I've hung out with them for a few years now. They're fantastic people that I'm really happy that I know. The Nobicon guys, same goes for them. I remember their first game where they came down to a burn game and, like, just seeing the pure excitement in them. And, like, they just went home and just turned, just went crazy on Nerf. And it was awesome to see. So they are definitely some of my favorite Nerfers and channels as well. You know, Bubba Lolo, guys, just a ton of fun. Walcom, Rob from Thunderdome, Rob from SBNC, Hawkeye 007, and I'm actually going to do a video in the future because there's really too many Nerfers to name. I subscribe to a lot of Nerf channels and enjoy watching like all of them, so I could sit here for a long time and name them, but I'm actually planning on doing a video in the future of channels that do Nerf War gameplay videos, because that's one of my favorite things to do, and I feel like they don't get as much exposure. It's not something that enough people know about, that there are these channels that do gameplay footage and show how much fun the hobby is and all the awesome games that happen. So I want to be able to share that, and that there are other people that are doing these types of videos. So look forward to that. It'll have more of the YouTubers that I really, really like and respect and enjoy knowing and hanging out with. And ones I don't know, but yeah, I could keep going for a long time on that. I'm just going to cut that off. There's probably like a million Nerf channels that I'm going to finish filming and be like, oh yeah, that, yeah. You know, like Evan B. Nerf and yeah, J Nerf. See, I'm just going to keep going if I don't stop. So I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop. I'm sorry. I'm going to keep going. The face place, do you plan on making more Overwatch content? Probably yes. Yeah, I think so. As long as the game stays fun, yeah, I'll probably continue. Most of that's been on the AoE channel, but I am going to start combining or start doing gaming stuff on this channel as well, since I only do one video a month for the AoE channel. I want to do more gaming content to supplement the Nerf content. So it's going to be a gaming and Nerf and like just general nerdiness channel. That was the original intention for this channel when I started. So I'd like to get it to that space. You know, Nerf stuff, I love it, and I'm going to keep doing it, and it's going to continue to, I think, always, as long as I can, be a part of this channel. But I want to do, you know, gaming as well, because I love gaming, just like I love Nerf. So I want to share that love with all of you. The Nerf Beaver asks, just a question, but what one thing that Nerf YouTubers like you or Lordrak or Bobolo should change, like something with your viewers? That's a hard one to answer, because the way I look at it is my channel is so incredibly small compared to either of their channels that clearly what they're doing is working, and I am not really in a position to say, oh yeah, they should be doing this instead, because clearly their channels are successful. So yeah, I don't know. As for myself, I gotta think about that one. Probably I don't know. There's a lot I want to do, a lot I want to change in terms of the style of content, the quality of content. I kind of feel like I always want to change and try new things. So maybe I should be trying to evolve the channel more often instead of sticking with certain things. So maybe that's something I could do. In terms of viewers, I like I said, I love interacting with you guys. So that's why I try to respond to every comment. That's why we have the Discord channel to hang out and talk, things like that. So yeah, I enjoy. Hopefully that vibrate didn't mess with the mic. I'm getting like a message or something. But yeah, hopefully I'm able to communicate with the viewers well enough. So yeah. Sorry that it took so long to get out. I just had to think about that for a minute. Lucas Smith asks, what would you like Hasbro, Buzzbee, Boomco to produce and why? What has me excited for Nerf in 2016? And what would you like to see more of in the Nerf community? Who is your biggest Nerf icon, role model besides myself? What makes the best game of Nerf? Venue, blaster, team of people, rule set. Okay, let's get into these. What would I like to see the big companies produce? I'd like to say blasters that are easier to mod, like they have less less stuff to get in the way of modding, but that's not going to happen because they don't want their blasters modded, so that's kind of right out the window. I think blasters that are distinctly geared towards performance and fun, like having separate lines that like, hey, here are blasters that are going to perform well, and here are blasters that are, you know, here's a gimmick, here's fun, because that is important. That's a very important aspect of the hobby. So I feel like having both is important. They don't need to be combined. You can have them separate, you know, it just, I think both need to be touched on. We so often glaze over the gimmicky blasters because they don't perform all that well. And we often forget that fun is a huge part of this hobby. Massively integral to the hobby and its continued growth. So I think the gimmicky blasters and the performance blasters need to stay around. Because like during the era of like the Elite first coming out, I'm trying to remember, I feel like there weren't a ton of like just fun, quirky blasters. I'm sure someone will comment with some that I'm not thinking of, but yeah, like blasters like the Sledge Fire, like my god, thing like performs awfully, but it's so much fun. I love it. Like we need to continue to have those, both of those things. So that's what I would like to see produced. If you can make gimmicky perform well, that's perfect. I'm a sucker for gimmicky. If I find it, like it's, I'm that guy. I'll buy the stupid blaster and run around with it. So that's me. What has me excited for Nerf in 2016? The new rival stuff to see how it changes the game. Looking forward to seeing if they release more Chaos Mags, what happens when people have lipoed them and are running them, or people that have singled Atlases that are shooting, you know, 110 FPS with rival stuff, you know, accurately. So curious to see just, yeah, how the game's going to evolve on the field. I see more of in the community. More intergroup interaction. So when groups from different areas kind of get together and have games together or talk online and kind of share ideas and stuff like that, I would love to see more groups intermingling. That, I think, is a big, big aspect of growth that I would like to see more of. Biggest Nerf icon role model besides myself. Certainly not my own role model, so that's not an issue. That's tough. I don't know. I don't know if I have one. I feel like I appreciate a lot of things that a lot of people do. I mean, maybe Rob from Thunderdome might be the best one to go with, because he, like, just his story and the fact that he was able to come back from such an awful experience and you know, make something so wonderful, and just continue to help people through it and try to spread the word about everything and just do good with his life. Like that, you know what? Yeah, that's probably the way I'd go. That's what I would say. I think that he's a role model for just about everyone in trying to better yourself and better others and push through, you know, terrible things that have happened to you. So yeah, that, respect to Rob. Dude is awesome. Just Joe asks, what is your favorite one-shot blaster? Again, you may consider it two-shot because the handle shoots, but yeah. Oh, I forgot to answer what makes the best game a Nerf. The people. Yeah, the people. You gotta have good people to play with. People that'll respect tags being called, people that don't get angry or, you know, too heated. Getting competitive is great. I love being competitive, but getting, like, crazy angry all the time, no, we're here to have fun. Like, it's the people that make a good Nerf game.
Is that it? Did we get there? Did we? Okay, what is your favorite loadout to use when playing with the Strife, Andrew Huss asks. We actually just talked about the last loadout to use. That's probably what I'd go with right now. EJ Gaming asks, what is
your name. All that's left is your name. I'm guessing he means where my name came from. So my name, Jengular, came from one of my favorite books growing up, which is called Marl Fox. It's a Brian Jacques book from the Redwall series. It's a series about animals that are personified or humanized. What's the right word? Whatever. They're animals that walk and talk and are act like humans, basically. But it's set in like medieval setting. And there was a character named Jengular Swifteye. And it was spelled J-A-N-G-L-U-R. And he was awesome. He was sweet. He was an awesome character that was my favorite. So when it came to naming myself online years later, I was like, oh, what's that character's name? Jengular. Yeah, it's Jengular. And I misspelt it. I butchered it completely. Like, I added an A and moved some letters around and came up with Jengular. And I just kind of stopped. Like, the name was unique. It's, like, almost never taken sometimes, which always confuses me, but it's rarely taken, which I love, and it's just kind of, become my name. So, yeah. Like, in gaming and Nerf and like every in cosplay and everything, it's been my name, so it's easy just to respond to it now. I don't know about the upcoming Clash Royale update. This was like almost a month ago, but yes, I did know about the Royale update. I haven't been playing a ton lately, so yeah. These names, I'm just going to be so bad. I'm so sorry, people. Andriha Ivankovich? Have you ever modded a Nerf Stampede? And if you have, what do you recommend to do with it? I tried to mod a Stampede. It went horribly. So I can't recommend much. I can say that when they are done properly, they're awesome. The sound they make is so satisfying. Oh my god. It's one of the best sounds in Nerf. But yeah, when I tried it, the cycling wouldn't stop, and it went to hell. It was bad. I messed it up bad. Aaron Pfeiffer asks, what other hobbies do you have besides Nerf and gaming? Besides those, cosplay was one. I haven't cosplayed in a few years, though. I would love to cosplay again. It was so much fun. It's a lot of work when you're making the costumes, and it gets really frustrating, but you can always buy costumes as well. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. I enjoy Lego stuff. I enjoy card games, like Magic and stuff like that. I think that... You know, making films, like short films and filming stuff, definitely a fan of, but most of that is Nerf stuff now, so yeah. Photography. Initially, before I switched to film and TV, I was a photography major in college, so yeah, that's one. Yeah, I think that's about it. Like, I've done martial arts in the past, but that's not something I would call a hobby now. Yeah. Yeah, that covers it. I think that actually brings us to the end of our questions. That was actually a lot more than I expected. I thought this was going to be a lot shorter video. So if you made it all the way through, thank you so much for your questions, for watching. Hopefully this was interesting for all of you. I know there was some repetition in some questions, but I wanted to get through them and make people feel like they're not getting neglected, because all the questions were important to me. So again, thank you all so much for asking the questions, and thank you all for supporting the channel. It's been wonderful to see the channel grow and just the community around it. You know, we've got the Discord now that people are hanging out and they're talking, and I love popping in, and I haven't been on, but I see this like long just conversation that's been happening, and it makes me really happy to see, because like I said earlier, the community and the people are such an important aspect of this hobby that continuing it and growing it is just wildly important to me. So thank you. I hope to continue to make content that you all enjoy for many, many years to come. and I hope you will all be around for it. So I think that does it. We'll close it out. As always, thank you so much for watching. Have fun flinging foam, and I'll see you next time.